Hi guys, so this is the video for May 4th, 2021 and myself Neha Gupta, I'm your mentor for current affairs. So without wasting any time, I will be starting with the video. And if you are the newcomer who is coming for the first time on our channel, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification so that you get the instant updates about the new uploads. Also guys, you can join our Telegram channel where we provide you with quizzes as well as you can directly connect with your mentors. So if you want to connect with us, then you can join this group by clicking the link in the description below. So this is our 2022 course. So I will give you a brief introduction of the course and then we will move ahead with the video of today. So in this course, we will be providing 10 mock tests for phase 1, finance and management, economics and social issues, English descriptive, as well as you will get assistance for your phase 3, that is interview round. So you will get a comprehensive set of tests as well as assessments to assess yourself and get good marks in your RBI grade examination. Next peculiar feature of this course is the book kit that we will be sending at your place. This book kit comprises of phase 1 question bank, phase 2 question bank, phase 2 revision booklet, phase 1 and 2 past year papers starting from the year 2010 onwards, a notebook and a pen. So if you are convinced to enroll in this course, then you can avail a 30% discount which is being run on this course by using the coupon code RBI30. And if you still have any queries regarding the course, then you can call at this number which is right in front of your screens and get your queries resolved. Now let's begin today's video with this first question. Which of the following operation has been launched by the Indian Navy for procuring oxygen from different countries to India in the wake of COVID-19? So this is, guys, a really very interesting as well as an important question because this is highlighting the efforts of Indian Navy as well as Indian government, all the Indian forces that have joined together to fight this COVID-19 pandemic. So one initiative is from the Indian Navy and that initiative is named as Operation Samudra Setu 2. That is option B. Now here I will be giving you a brief about different operations that have been launched by the Indian Navy to overcome this crisis of COVID-19. The first initiative is Operation Samudra Setu 1. This initiative was launched in May 2020 to bring back Indians who have stranded overseas due to the COVID-19 travel restrictions. So this Operation Samudra Setu Part 1 was for that. And now at this point of time, that is in May 2021, this Operation Samudra Setu Part 2 has been launched, in which the oxygen and related equipments as well as related medicines will be brought to the country. And apart from this, allied equipments, allied medicines will also be brought so that this COVID-19 pandemic can be fought diligently in it. So these are the two missions, Operation Samudra Setu Part 1 and Operation Samudra Setu Part 2. Apart from this, a very key mission was also launched by Indian Navy and the name of that mission is Operation Sagar. So this Operation Sagar 1 that you are seeing in the option C, this mission was also launched in May 2020 when COVID reached its peak, and the aim of this Operation Sagar 1 was to provide the medicines, health and other humanitarian assistance to the countries which are in the neighborhood of India, in the Indian Ocean region. Basically, the countries that are in the Indian Ocean region will be getting assistance from India, assistance in terms of health equipments, in terms of medicines, in terms of food in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic. So basically, it has also been launched in two phases. First phase was in May 2020 and second phase was launched around August 2020. So these are the two key operations that have been launched by Indian Navy. Now that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to our next question. I hope that you have understood it well, but in case if you have any queries, then do not hesitate in asking your queries to us in the comment section below, as well as you can also ask these queries on the Telegram group. Moving ahead to the next question, which is related to your banking and economy. And guys, do focus on this question because banking and economy is a very important section from your banking exam point of view, especially if you are appearing for SEBI exam or RBI exam. So moving ahead, we have question number two. Which bank has launched a special deposit scheme named Immune India Deposit Scheme to encourage people to get COVID-19 vaccines? So we have Central Bank of India, Indian Overseas Bank, Punjab and Sindh Bank, Bank of Maharashtra and UCO Bank in the options. Out of these five options, option A, that is Central Bank of India, is the right answer. Now this is a very interesting initiative that has been taken up by a public sector bank, and this bank aims to increase the reach of vaccination through this scheme. So the scheme, Immune India Deposit Scheme, aims to provide an additional interest rate of 0.25%, that is 25 basis points, to the customers who are enrolling in this scheme. But there is a condition, and that condition is that you should get vaccination before enrolling in this scheme. So through this scheme, through this method, by using the monetary method, this bank is trying to increase the spread of vaccination in India. So this is such a great initiative, and there are high chances that this question can come up in your upcoming examinations. So do focus on it. Now, your task is to find out the tagline of Central Bank of India. That is your homework for today. Next question is, who has been chosen for the post of CMD, that is Chairman and Managing Director of BEML Limited? So you have five options: Amit Banerjee, Upendra Prasad Singh, Bijoy Kumar Singh, Shashi Ranjan Kumar, Nihar Ranjan Dash. So out of these five options, option A, that is Amit Banerjee, is the CMD of BEML. Now guys, this position or this appointment has been made by this board, that is Public Enterprises Selection Board. And recently, the chairperson of this board has also been appointed. So who is that chairperson? It is Mallika Srinivasan. So this is a very important appointment, guys. Mallika Srinivasan, the chairperson of Public Enterprises Selection Board, has been made recently, and she has taken, she has assumed charge of her office very recently. So this is also a recent news and can come up in your examination. So do remember that this PESB has recommended the selection of Amit Banerjee on the post of CMD of BEML Limited. Next question is again from our appointment section. Who has been appointed as the MD of Kotak Mahindra Life Insurance Company Limited? So you have five options again. Out of these five options, the right answer is option D, that is Mahesh Balasubramanian. Apart from this, you also know this thing, that who is the MD of Kotak Mahindra Bank? It is Uday Kotak. So these were the two important appointments. These were the two important designations related to this news. So here comes our next question, which is from the sports section. So where will the 2021 ASBC Asian Elite Men and Women Boxing Championship be held? So you have five options. Out of these five options, guys, can you make a guess where will this ASBC Asian Elite Men and Women Boxing Championship be held? So let me tell you, let me resolve this riddle for you. The right answer here is option B, that is Dubai. Earlier, the scheduled venue was Delhi, but now it has been shifted to Dubai because of this COVID-19 pandemic. So this is the news only that you have to remember. 2021 ASBC Asian Elite Men and Women Boxing Championship is scheduled to take place in Dubai. With this is our last question that we are going to discuss. After this question, we will be taking a due to you guys. But do listen to me very carefully in this question, because this is one of the most important questions in today's video. So let's begin this question. Recently, Indian Army has inaugurated the first green solar energy harnessing plant of KVA using vanadium-based battery technology in Dash at an altitude of 16,000 feet. So basically, this first green solar energy harnessing plant is located at an altitude of 16,000 feet. So where is it located? It is located in Sikkim. North Sikkim is the right answer. And do remember the capacity of this plant, that is 56 kilowatt. So that was all about this question, guys. Now this is time to bid adieu to you. I hope that you have enjoyed and learned a lot. In this session, I have tried to keep the information precise and concise so that you can cover up a lot in less time. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, then do hit the thumbs up and share this video among your friends. Thank you so much for watching the video.